It is good to worship together. We give thanks for the ways in which God connects us near and far. God created us to be generous people. And we give thanks too for the ways you share your abundance with those around you. As you go about your week, consider the opportunities you encounter to give to others just as God has given to you. We join in confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is eager to forgive and who loves us beyond our days. Amen. Together we acknowledge our failure to love this world as Jesus does. God of mercy and forgiveness, we confess that sin still has a hold on us. We have harmed your good creation. We have failed to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with you. Turn us in a new direction. Show us the path that leads to life. Be our refuge and strength on the journey. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. Beloved of God, your sins are forgiven, and you are made whole. God points the way to new life in Christ, who meets us on the road. Journey now in God's abiding love, through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
There are the woodlands. wandering spirit sing. Fair is the sunshine, fair is the moonlight, bright the sparkling stars on high. Jesus shines brighter, Jesus shines purer than all the angels in the sky. Beautiful Savior,
Let us pray. O God, our true life, to serve you is freedom, and to know you is unending joy. We worship you, we glorify you, we give thanks for you, for your great glory. Abide with us, reign in us, and make this world into a fit habitation for your divine majesty. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Colossians. May you be made strong with all the strength that comes from his glorious power, and may you be prepared to endure everything with patience while joyfully giving thanks to the Father who has enabled you to share in the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has rescued us from the power of darkness, transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him all things in heaven and earth were created, things visible and invisible. Whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers, all things have been created through him and for him. He himself is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross. The word of the Lord.
The Gospel according to Luke. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself if he's the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine, and saying, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the king of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanging there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Today is Christ the King Sunday. It's the last day of the church year.
The day we proclaim intentionally that Jesus is God's way of ruling this world and all that is to come, we're intentional in saying that Jesus is indeed King of the universe. It's New Year's Eve on the church calendar, and one might think that we would celebrate by hearing the story of Jesus' resurrection, but instead, today we have the story of Jesus hanging on the cross. The people expected Jesus to overthrow the powers of oppression. They expected Jesus to enter the city with an army to conquer those who abused their power. They expected vindication, and God gave them Jesus with triumph that looked like a failure. We're not unlike the people then wanting Jesus to do something about the reality of their lives. I can't tell you how many times I've screamed at God to do something, to not just stand there, to not just be there watching the suffering of the world, but act, call game over, redeem this broken world and all of us in it. And we too are given Jesus, not a king who rules with bigger weapons and not a king who is protected by Secret Service and who boasts about possessions, and certainly not a king who has courts of servants. We are given Jesus, a king who is humble, a king who doesn't take away our suffering, but enters into it with us. A king who leads the way, leading by example rather than through fear and retaliation. It takes intention for us today to remember that Jesus' life, death, and resurrection did not occur in a church building. There are times when we separate Jesus from the world we live in, from the world of divisive politics, from hate speech, from missiles lighting up the night sky in countries around the globe, and from the gun violence we've become, on some level, numb to. Jesus was killed outside the city between two criminals, on a hill used for executions that they called the Skull. One of the criminals hanging there with Jesus said, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." Later in the conversation, the other criminal said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." My conversations with Jesus vary. Sometimes I'm saying, "Are you not the Messiah? You should be here saving us." And other times I say, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus is always replying, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." And Jesus says the same to you and to the whole world. Today on Christ the King Sunday, we celebrate the King of the universe, the one who entered into the human story, who suffered with us and by us, who continues to bring about the kingdom of God, when one day there will be indeed no more brokenness, no more suffering, no more pain. Jesus says to you today, wherever your heart is, truly today you will be with me in paradise. Jesus is with you now, in the midst of your everyday lives, and Jesus promises for a day to come when all will be made well, and all will be rejoicing, when the kingdom of God is made complete. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords is here, is there, with you, and will be forever. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us confess our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
United with your saints across time and place, we pray for our shared world. We pray for your church. Embolden denominations and faith-based organizations in creative and collaborative ministries, and increase our work for the sake of the gospel. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. We pray for the earth. Protect waterways from pollution and animal habitats from destruction. Guide us in careful stewardship of waters, plant life, and animals. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. We pray for the nations of the world. Instill in every leader's heart a desire for justice and peace. Support the work of international collaborations that seek the goals of health and joy for all people. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. We pray for all who are undermined or oppressed. Amplify the voices of the unheard and break open stubborn systems of injustice. Bring about your righteousness and fill us all with your redeeming light. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. We pray for this assembly. Guide our pastors, deacons, and council members in discernment and nurture new leaders with fresh ideas. Give this congregation a spirit of discipleship and service. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayers. We give thanks for all who have died in the faith. Console us who mourn and comfort us with the beautiful promise of life in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, receive our prayer. Accept these prayers, gracious God, and those known only to you, through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
King, help us thy name to sing, help us to praise, Father, all glorious, O'er all victorious, come and reign over us, Ancient of Days. Come thou incarnate Word, merciful mighty Lord, attend. Come and thy people bless, and give thy word success, and let thy righteousness on us descend. Come, Holy Comforter, thy sacred witness bear, in this glad hour, thou who almighty art, Spirit of power. To thee, great one in three, eternal praises be, as evermore, thy sovereign majesty may we in glory see, and to eternity love and adore.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.